Good morning, church. It's Thursday morning, and we want to look at the Word of God once again. We're going to be back in chapter number 15. And sometimes it's hard to not get caught up with all the details that you find in the book of Revelation. So let me very quickly rehash what's going on. In chapter number 1, we see the revelation of Jesus Christ. Chapter number 2 and 3, we saw instructions to the church and the church age. And then chapter 4 and 5, we saw the church up in heaven. Remember, in chapter number 6, we began a study on what's going on during the 7-year tribulation period here on the earth. And what is happening is we see 7 seals that are opened, and each one has a new revelation of something that's going to happen on the earth. The first seal was the Antichrist and his coming to power. Then there were wars in number 2. Number 3 was pestilences and plagues that come upon the earth. And then there was death. Then there was martyrdom in the 5th seal. The 6th seal was cosmic disturbances that began to happen on the earth, that God even reveals through unnatural things. Things are happening in the heavens, what's going to happen on the earth. But then there was a 7th seal that was open. And if you remember, when that 7th seal was open, that led to 7 trumpets. Trumpets of judgment. And most of those are brought about, I believe, because mankind brings ruin upon the earth. But there was a great portion of the vegetation that was destroyed. The second trumpet was the seas were destroyed. Then the fresh waters were destroyed. The 4th, the sun, the moon, the stars began to have things happening there. Then there were demons in the 5th trumpet that were released upon the earth like a plague of locusts. For a short period of time, those uncontrollable demons that God has put in a place right now of holding, because they will not even do what, they'll go past the limits God has set upon the demons to do. And they're going to be unleashed for a period of time. And then the next plague, the 6th, trumpet was sounding, was released of some uncontrollable demons who are going to go about and begin to draw people in the nations towards demonic forces. And then we saw the 7th trumpet. So again, we have the 7 seals, and when we got to the 7th seal, then we had 7 trumpets. Well, when the 7th trumpet is blown, there are the final acts of God's apocalyptic judgment that comes upon the earth. So that's where we're at. We're in the 7th trumpet that has sealed or has gone forth, has been blown. And now we're going to see God pouring out wrath. And there's this great ceremony that takes place. And each one of these are called a bowl of God's wrath. It's a container that contains God's wrath, and it's going to pour out upon the earth. So verse 1 of chapter 15 says, "Then I saw another sign in heaven, great and marvelous, 7 angels having the last 7 plagues, for in them where the wrath of God is going to be complete. And I saw something like a sea of glass mingled with fire, and those who have victory over the beast, over his image and over his mark, and over the number of his name, standing on the sea of glass, having harps of God." And so before heaven pours out its wrath, he says, "I saw this beautiful scene of many people standing before the throne of God, and there's this sea of glass, and it's very orderly, very serene. And before God pours out his wrath, there's this ceremony. And coming out of the temple of God is going to be these 7 angels who are going to pour out these bowls of wrath." And so they have these 7 bowls of wrath. And so this is view of heaven's glory and the saints' praise before God pours out his wrath upon the earth. And it says about these that are standing there singing, he says, "And they sing the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb, saying, Great and marvelous are your works, Lord God Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O King of the saints. Who shall not fear you, O Lord, and glorify your name? For you alone are holy, for all the nations shall come and worship before you, for your judgments have been manifested." And so God is about to take control of the earth once again. He's always been in control, but he's going to send Christ to the earth, and he's going to rule the earth. But before that, there's this great ceremony that takes place, and this song. Now, it's amazing this is a song that is sung. He says he calls it the Song of Moses. The Song of Moses was sung, if you remember, at the Red Sea after God had destroyed the army of the Egyptians. And so God had delivered his people from Satan, from Pharaoh, and he's destroyed the army of the Egyptians. And now it was time for Israel to rule herself as a nation. Then he says the Song of the Lamb, and that is now God is going to destroy Babylon, and he's going to destroy the final empire, Rome. He's going to destroy the Antichrist, and the one behind Antichrist is Satan. He's going to destroy all these things, and he's going to do it at a great battle, and he's going to do it at the Battle of Armageddon, and it's going to happen just as he saw. And so one was before Crystal Sea of Glass, the other was before the Red Sea. And Satan is going to be destroyed in Babylon. So all this is a ceremony and a celebration of what is about to happen. So we're at the very end of the tribulation period, right before Christ's return. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you that you've given us insight as to who's going to win all this. That certainly the saints are going to be in your presence, and certainly Christ is going to rule the earth. And Father, we thank you that we can celebrate even now before it all happens, that Father, you are going to be the one who rules over all things, and we are your servants. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.